In this video, we're continuing on with the free KutaSoftware worksheet, the Midpoint Formula. You can find this worksheet within the geometry section, and I'll leave a link in the description below so you know where to find this worksheet. In this video, I'm going to complete numbers 9 through 20, and our directions are to find the midpoint of the line segment within the given endpoints. So real quickly, I'm going to remind you of the midpoint formula. If you need a more in-depth explanation, please go to the previous video or go to my geometry tutorial section on YouTube and look up midpoint formula. So the midpoint M equals x1 plus x2 all over 2, comma y1 plus y2 all over 2. So we're finding the halfway point between the x coordinates, and we're finding the halfway point between the y coordinates. And x1, y1, and x2, y2 are the endpoints of my segment. Knowing this, let's look at number 9. In number 9, x1, y1, x2, y2. So I'm going to use my formula M, plug in x1 plus x2, so that's going to be negative 4 plus 5, and I'm going to divide that by 2, comma 4 plus negative 1 for my y1, y2, and divide that by 2 as well. Negative 4 plus 5 is going to be a positive 1 over 2, and 4 plus negative 1 is going to be a positive 3 over 2. So now I have 1 half, 3 halves as my coordinate, but I'm going to write 3 halves as a mixed number. So this is going to be 1 half, 1, and 1 half. And that's my answer in number 9. Let's move on to number 10. In number 10, we're given that our endpoints are negative 1, negative 6. So here's x1, y1, and we have negative 6, 5, x2, and y2. So for M, we're going to have x1, negative 1, plus x2, negative 6, all over 2, comma, y1, negative 6, plus y2, 5, all over 2. Simplifying, negative 1 plus negative 6 is going to be negative 7 over 2, negative 6 plus 5 is going to be negative 1, and that is also over 2. So writing negative 7 halves, we're going to get negative 3 and a half, and then negative 1 half. So negative 3 and a half, negative 1 half is our solution in number 10. In number 11, just to show you that the order of the endpoint doesn't necessarily matter, I'm going to make 2 and 4, x2 and y2, and I'm going to make 1 and negative 3, x1 and y1. So now when I'm using my midpoint formula, I'm going to have 1 plus 2, and we're dividing that by 2, and then I'm going to have negative 3 plus 4, and I'm dividing that by 2 as well. 1 plus 2 will give me 3, and we're dividing that by 2, and you can see for my numerator in my y-coordinate, negative 3 plus 4 will give me a positive 1. And then we're dividing that by 2. 3 halves can be rewritten as 1 1/2, so my final answer is 1 1/2, 1 1/2. So remember, for endpoints x1, y1, and x2, y2, it doesn't matter which coordinate we're using, just as long as in our formula, our x-coordinates are added within our x-coordinate, and our y-coordinates are added within our y-coordinate. In number 12, for the midpoint, I'm going to have negative 4 plus negative 2, x1 and x2, and that's going to be divided by 2, and then I'm going to have 4 plus 2, y1 and y2, and that's going to be divided by 2. Negative 4 plus negative 2 is negative 6, and that's divided by 2. 4 plus 2 is a positive 6, and that's divided by 2 as well. Negative 6 divided by 2 is a negative 3, and 6 divided by 2 is a positive 3. So my solution in number 12 is negative 3, 3. For number 13, I'll have 5 plus negative 4, so adding my x-coordinates, dividing that by 2, and then 2 plus negative 3, adding the y coordinates of my endpoints, and then dividing those by 2. 5 plus negative 4 is going to be positive 1, and we're dividing that by 2. 2 plus negative 3 is a negative 1, and we're dividing that by 2. So my final solution is 1/2, negative 1/2. For number 14, my x coordinates, negative 1 plus 5, and we're dividing those by 2. And then finally, my y coordinates for my endpoints, adding those, positive 1 plus a negative 5, and dividing that by 2. Negative 1 plus a positive 5 is going to give me a positive 4, dividing by 2. 1 plus negative 5 is going to be a negative 4, and we're dividing that by 2. 4 divided by 2 is 2. Negative 4 divided by 2 is negative 2. 2, negative 2 is my solution in number 14. In number 15, adding 2 and negative 6 and dividing those by 2 for my x coordinate, then adding negative 1 and 0 and dividing those by 2 for my y coordinate. That gives me 2 plus negative 6 is negative 4, dividing by 2, and then negative 1 plus 0 is negative 1 over 2. So my final solution, negative 4 divided by 2, is negative 2, and then negative 1/2. Number 16 looks different because now, as opposed to using just whole numbers for our endpoints, we're using decimals. However, the same formula still applies. We're going to have x1, y1, and x2, y2. So for our midpoint, we're going to add negative 3.1 to negative 4.92, and then we're dividing that by 2, and we're going to add negative 2.8 to negative 3.3, and we're going to divide that by 2. So negative 3.1 plus negative 4.92 will give me a negative 8.02, and we're dividing that by 2, adding our y coordinates, negative 2.8 plus negative 3.3 is going to give us a negative 6.1, or 6 1/10, and we're dividing that by 2. So our final solution, we're taking negative 8 2/100 and dividing that by 2, so negative 8.02 divided by 2 gives us negative 4.01, and negative 6.1 divided by 2 will give us a negative 3.05. So negative 4 1/100 and negative 3 5/100 is our solution in number 16. In number 17, adding the x's, then dividing by 2, and then adding the y's and dividing by 2. Negative 5.1 plus 1.4 is going to give me negative 3.7, and we're dividing that by 2, and then we have negative 2 plus 1.7, which will be a negative 0.3, so negative 3/10, and we're dividing that by 2. Negative 3.7 divided by 2 is negative 1.85, and negative 0.3, or negative 3/10 divided by 2, is negative 0.15. Negative 1.85, negative 0.15. That's my solution in number 17. In number 18, adding my x coordinates, 4.9 to negative 5.2, that'll give me a negative 0.3. And we're dividing that by 2, and then adding our y coordinates, negative 1.3 to negative 0.6 will give me negative 1.9, and we're dividing that by 2. Negative 0.3 divided by 2 is going to be negative 0.15, and negative 1.9 divided by 2 is going to be a negative 0.95. So negative 0.15 and negative 0.95. Or you can think of this as negative 15 hundredths and negative 95 hundredths. In number 19, we're adding our x's. 5.1 plus 6 is going to be 11.1, and that's divided by 2. And then 5.71 plus 3.6 is going to be a positive 9.31. And that's also divided by 2. 11.1 divided by 2 is going to be 5.55. So that's the value of our x coordinate for the midpoint. And for the y coordinate, 9.31 divided by 2 is going to be 4.655. So 4.655 is our y coordinate for our midpoint. 5.55, 4.655 is our solution in number 19. And finally, the last problem in this video, number 20. We're adding our x coordinates, 3.1 to negative 0.52. 3.1 plus negative 0.52 is going to be 2.58. So we'll have 2.58, and we're dividing that by 2, since that's our x1 plus x2, and then we're dividing that by 2. And then when we add y1 plus y2, we're going to get negative 2.1 plus negative 0.6, which will be negative 2.7, and we're dividing that by 2. So for our final solution, 2.58 divided by 2 is a positive 1.29. And negative 2.7 divided by 2 is a negative 1.35. So 1.29 negative 1.35 is our solution for the midpoint in number 20, using the endpoint 3.1, negative 2.1, and the other endpoint negative 0.52, negative 0.6. If you found this video helpful, please remember to give me a thumbs up and like this video. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And if you have any questions or need further clarification, go ahead and leave a comment below.